Hello everyone, it's Mrs. Azar. Just wanted to talk to you today about creating a beach landscape. So I'm going to use crayon for this drawing as well as graphite from my pencil. I had started a drawing last night of this with pencil in a sketch, and I used this picture as a reference. So right now I want to just go over some of the parts that we see in this picture. Back here we see the horizon line, and we're going to be using that line in our drawing to separate our areas of sky and earth. Okay, so once I have this mapped out in this areas, I'm going to start to draw the objects that I have. So one of the big things that I have to lay in as another area is this coastline that you see over here with the wave action meeting the sand. So I'm just going to use a squiggly line to go down the side of this drawing in an almost diagonal shape. Now there's another part of this picture where we use a technique called overlap, where we are taking a object that is very close to the viewer and it is up front, and that I'm going to place here on this side of my drawing, just coming from the side. All right, this coconut palm tree. So we've done some of these drawings in class where we use the shape of this compound leaf coming from a center, just like the top of this. I'm gonna just add some of these leaves. So I've laid in some of the basics of this design. And we're going to just deal with some of the value that we see before we use our crayons to color. And of course, finishing off the layers of this tree with some more color once we get the background shaded in. All right, so to start off, I'm going to use my pencil on this sideways and just lay in a soft value for the top of the sky. As the sky moves down to the horizon, the value will get lighter, but it's still some value here in the sky, not bright white. So leave this area for later. I can use color. So one of the things when you're doing shading, you will need to sharpen your pencil more often. Points will wear off to the side. Another great pencil to use is a full graphite pencil. It will always have some graphite even towards the end without a point, even the side of the pencil. All right, so we're gonna, like I said, drew a little too much. Okay, so once we have the value laid out in the sky, and I've finished off some of this in both sides of the tree, because we will have a little background here. Your background being what's behind everything else, or off to the distance, very often. And then here we start to have a little more value here into the water as the change of color occurs. So our skies being very blue, even light blue, and here in the water starting to have this green color, which tends to be a little darker as a hue from this lighter blue. Also, you want to designate where the crashing of the waves has a very white, bright white area in the picture. As we draw currents in the ocean or any water bodies that we are putting in our pictures, you want to keep those lines to show the texture of the water in a horizontal plane. Now, one of the things that happens when you are close up in the picture, something that's going to happen here with this palm tree, you see more detail. So you can see some of the detail of these rocks here in my drawing. I'm going to have this area and the waves, maybe a rock is coming in. I can kind of invent some of this. Just use the picture as a reference, but it doesn't have to be perfect. Okay, so. All right, so like I said, we were going to deal with some of this palm tree. This will also have some value. Another thing about these coconut palm tree style is that the tree bark kind of grows in this circular pattern. So you will see these ring shapes to it. As I'm shading, again, that sideways pencil soft, but building up value. Now there's going to be a lot more value towards the center of this tree as all of the leaves cluster in. All right, so now I want to just talk to you about laying in some of the value here in the sand. Also, this picture, we could have some trees off in the distance. Some of this you can detail, or kind of just make it a very distant shadow. Grasses, bushes. All right, so let's just use our side pencil and add some of the value of that water, sand. Right, so kind of have some basics here, just some of the little bit of the shape for some of the major objects, and finishing off the shading, which will be colored on top of with crayon. All right, so stay tuned. We're gonna continue with color, hopefully. So also to come back in here, we want to lay out our clouds, areas that might have a little darker value around them, and then brighter white.